Good evening, sir. My name is Vasudha Tyagarajan. I'm a law student, actually. Firstly, I would like to thank you for giving us such an informative talk on terrorism and Islam. My question is, what do you think is the reason for the sudden increase in the number of terrorist organizations which are basically Islamic and they fight in the name of Islam? And since you say that Islam is giving the guidelines is that women, children, elderly people shouldn't be injured or killed, but there have been various bomb blasts and killings of women and children. What do you think is the reason for that? Thank you.
The sisters asked a very relevant question, that what is the reason that there's increase in terrorist organization among the Muslims and so many bomb blasts, and especially when Islam says you should not kill children, etc. What is the reason? And that's a very good question. Personally, tell you again that personally I haven't met and interviewed any so-called 100% hardcore terrorist. I haven't met. But I can give the reasons, the logical answers why such thing may be happening. Number one, some people may really be terrorizing the innocent people. Some Muslims may be on the wrong track. They may not be following the guidance of the Quran. Like you have black sheep in every community. One of the number one terrorists of human history, who it is? It is Hitler. He has incinerated 6 million Jews. So can I blame Christianity for that? Hitler was a Christian. So I can't say because Hitler incinerated 6 million Jews, therefore Christianity says that you have to. He alone, if you add up all the terrorist organization put together, I doubt whether they'll reach 6 million. One individual alone. Again, Mussolini. Mussolini is a Christian. So just because Mussolini killed thousands of innocent people, that does not mean I can blame Christianity for that. So there may be certain black sheep in the community. Black sheep may be calling themselves Muslims and may be in the wrong, maybe. Point number two. It can be that there are people who are harassed. Like you ask me that today there is no Indian fighting for the freedom of the country. Do you find any Indian fighting for the freedom of the country? No. But 100 years back, there were several. So if you ask me, Brother Zakir, why did 100 years back there were many Indians fighting for the freedom? Because the British government ruled India. That's the reason people are fighting for their freedom. Today the British government has gone back. So no one is fighting for the freedom. So maybe these Muslims may actually be harassed. They may be being harassed. And you find this in several parts of the world, in Palestine, etc. That you find that maybe if you go to the history, if you go back to the history and you find that they have really been harassed, and if no one is coming out to help them, they are resorting to whatever means they have. Like the example which is given in the Bible, David and Goliath. The stone was sufficient. So who's to blame? We are to blame. We are to blame that we aren't going to the root cause of the problem. If there's a terrorist organization, we have to go and really find out what is the reason that they have resorted to terrorism. The only way we can solve this problem, just by killing them, these terrorists, it will not solve the problem. If you kill one, there will be 10 emerging. What we have to do, we have to go and find out what is the reason. Why are you resorting to this method? We have to go back to the root cause. It is like giving the example of Palestine. When Hitler incinerated 6 million Jews, the Jews were kicked out from Germany. And the Palestinians, they said, Ellen was Ellen. You are our cousins. Come and join us. It is like I tell a stranger that if you have a problem, come and stay in my house. After a few years, he kicks me out of the house. And when I start making a noise outside my house, that see, these people have entered my house, so you call me a terrorist. Am I a terrorist? I was welcome a person as a stranger. Just as a human brother, I got him to the house. After a few months, he kicks me out. And when I say that I want my house back, you say that I'm a terrorist. Who's to blame? We are to blame. We are to blame. We have to find out that what is the cause of the problem. If we, who Almighty God has given us intelligence, has given even the power and to get together, if we get to the root cause, you will come to know that why should a person want to die? Who would like to die? Who would like to die? A person who says that I say I'm going to get killed, so why not I die and take somebody else also? So if you ask the psychologist, they will tell you the root cause is we have to go and ask these people that why are doing all this, and many a time you'll find out that the truth is lying behind it. And the truth is that they may be being harassed, and some people may really be terrorists. Some people may be terrorists and the people for money. Some people for fame, some people for politics. So I do agree, sister, that but majority what I feel that they are being troubled whether it be Muslim, whether it be Hindu, whether it be Christians, there has to be a backlash. If a person cannot bear whatever torture that he's undergoing, he resorts, the psychologists say, and I'm a medical doctor, I have done my studies in medicine, they have to retaliate. It is human nature. So why should a person who would not like to raise a finger would like to carry a gun in the hand? Why? So what we have to do, we have to find the root cause and try and solve this problem. That's the only way we can see to it that these terrorizing the innocent people will stop and all human beings can live together as one brotherhood.